Now as you sung forth the honor of chivalry.
Is your majesty.
I am Maestra Osprey, finally.
well-spoken from the Order of Defense. In addition to her existing role, we would ask, is there another royal peer who would speak to you? Not just those who have done great deeds on the field or with their arts or with their service, but all of us have shared this dream together, including every single member of the populace. Is there anyone in the populace that would speak for this candidate at this time?
I'll speak. My first best step as a young kid, and his friends used to take broken broomsticks and whack at each other until they were all busted up. I told him there was a better way and brought him out to a private fighter practice, but all he needed was a cup. So I picked him up to take him out to fighter practice, and he didn't have a cup. He assured me he didn't need one. So I made him stop and get one anyway, and he repeatedly jumped in the air while fighting, and we hit him in the groin at least 4 or 5 times that day. So on the way home, he thanked me for taking him to fighter practice and for buying him a cup. He has always been like a son to me. He is a great person, a great fighter, and has the biggest heart of anybody I've ever met. He is a peer.
A few months ago, Steph stopped by our house to pick up something for some event, and he wanted to pop in, pop out. He ended up spending the entire afternoon talking to my daughter, my child, and encouraging her at a point when she was starting to become despondent, starting to become wondering if she should fight. And there was this huge guy, this large man, my small child, and him telling her not what she needed to work on, not what she needed to do right, but what he sees in her and why he sees her as going to be a great fighter. That is Peter. He is
Peter. These words are good to hear, and may reaffirm what Her Majesty and I knew to be true. And let us know that this decision is right, and the circle is right and just in bringing forward on this. In addition to words, would also see you don the trappings of a knight. And we have a sword for this king.
Good evening. My name is Angus McGowan. Those who don't know me. I had the big piece laid out.
Of the tools of knighthood. Spurs were used to urge the knight forward into battle, and the willingness to stop when necessary before committing a rash or wrong act. Spurs also represent the mastery of the knight's own self. The mastery of a horse is useless if the knight cannot control his own behavior. Without wisdom, kindness, and honor, no road can be traveled safely. These are the spurs of the knight. Shows to all that all men, the man himself, must work constantly to keep his honor unstained. All fail at perfection. But the
chain for this candle.
This is the chain of a knife. A simple item that holds so much meaning. It's impossible for what it means to be a knife. The circle completes from the host to the crown. Each link separates, yet brings together the knife and all the values the knife holds. Honor, justice, humility. It is our link to the crown and our link to the people. The humbling idol, its weight has meaning. This chain was not brought in new. It has a lineage. This chain was presented to our order by Duke Stephen of Bellatrix, of the ancient house of Bellatrix. For not if Steph got knighted, but when he got knighted.
This time, take your oath of fealty.
I take your name. Should they let you keep the crown at all? And I'll apply my arms and sign the oath. My heart in time of peace.
Oaths broken, words forgotten, to be met with a horrible decapitation. Oh, and our dreadful.
We honor your fealty at this time. Don't go anywhere. Take your place among your equals. Arise, Sir Steph, Knight of Glenarvan.
Last blow you receive on that.
way.